there's a rainbow. Oh my god. Wow. Let's see if I can. Oh wow. Oh wow. That was fun. Such a beautiful day after it rained. Everything feels alive. And welcome back to another video with me, Shruti Vashisht. You're watching Living Our Ascension. So today I wanted to film while it was raining. I just thought that it might be a good idea to try and see if you like the sensual sounds that are behind me with the rain and everything. So I hope that you do. But last week I wasn't able to film quite a bit because it just felt like a time for integration. Like, there was a lot that was coming through, but I didn't have the vocabulary for it. So usually when that happens, there's things that are happening in our embodiment process, but it hasn't fully integrated. So I wanted to wait, but hopefully this week I'll have a lot more to share with you. So please subscribe to this channel if you'd like to receive more videos. I do these weekly readings that are free, and then I have a whole bunch of other videos as well on self-mastery. So, also, you can check out my services on my website, which will be below this video. You can work personally with me to accelerate your self-mastery. And I also have services for, these type of messages like you're getting in this video. But, of course, they'll be personally tailored to you. I'm just really enjoying this rain. That's why I can't stop smiling. But anyway, okay, so what you have to do now is either pick number 1, number 2 or number 3, and we are going to get into our messages. You can scroll through this video and find the slots for 1, 2 and 3, and you'll find your message there. We're using this deck called Return of Spirit, so I hope that you like it. When we have eclipses, in the year, we have a few eclipses, and those are the biggest changes that happen within that year. So big things, changing homes, moving, change of job, relationship changes, or just internally. It's like that the most important events in your life that change, externally, happen during the eclipses. They're triggered during the eclipses. So I feel that, the eclipse is bringing that to you. It's bringing some significant change. So if you chose number 1, we're just going to pick a card for you right now. And this is the one that you get. It's called Take Flight. So you can see these cards are really good for light codes if that's what you're into. You can see the beautiful colors here. That it's magenta and golden, which are the colors of sort of they're really these high vibrational colors. Like, magenta is the color of divine love. I should probably come closer if I'm not audible enough because of the rain. But magenta is the color of divine love, which is all about rebuilding. And golden is the color of self-mastery, you know, it's like related to the Buddha, the Christ. So when we embody our Christ light or our Buddha light, the light of enlightenment, basically. So what I feel for you is that there's a lot that's going on inside of yourself. It might not be so external right at this moment. You might be getting cues that things are changing in your external. They're just becoming more graceful, more powerful, you know, more to do with your alignment. You know, everything is changing in the external pretty drastically as well. But as you can see, this activity is happening inside of you first. So just like this is happening inside, it's going to happen on the outside too, or you can already feel it. You may have a sense of how things are getting rearranged, you know. It's like, you know, when you look at this, it's very vibrational. So it's kind of like you have come into a new perspective of yourself. It's like a new self concept, and because of that, things are rearranging in your life. And I don't know, I feel like I need to keep saying that there's a significant shift, and it makes sense because we have the eclipse also coming up now on the 5th, right? So so I feel that, you know, the eclipse is bringing that to you. It's bringing some significant change, it's gonna start happening physically as well if it hasn't. And but you know, it's nothing to be scared of. This is actually, these are really high vibrational colors, so sometimes we have to let go of certain perceptions that we've had, that we've held. This is for ourselves, what we knew ourselves to be, and we just let that go and let this light take over and show us what we really are. And in a similar way, you know, all of those higher visions that we had about ourselves, we knew, it's like we experienced our own self, you know, our divinity. And in alignment with that, we had these desires. We desired more purity or more alignment in the external too. So so that is being fulfilled. You know, this is a really high vibrational card. So so there is some surrender, but there are some beautiful alignments that are happening for you internally as well as externally. If you chose number 2, then let's pick a card here. Maybe I'll go with this one, and you get the violet flame. So the violet flame, I want you to really look at this picture. If you've never seen or heard of the violet flame, this can be one way that you imagine it, because the violet flame is a tool. It's like the spiritual tool that we use to really transform from within, you know, all of those. It's the most potent tool that you can use to transform old karma, you know, old patterns that you've held in your body, or you feel you still associate with somehow, and you would like to transform them into true perception, you know, into because nothing is really stagnant, nothing is, you know, darkness. All of that does not really exist. We just label it that way, and then we hold on to it, and we, you know, create such realities. But in truth, everything is made of light. Everything that is manifested in your outer reality, everything that is inside of you, it's all made of light. So of course, everything is light. So using the violet flame, you can actually transform what you are feeling by loving it, and it becomes, you know, purified in a sense. So the color violet is also related to manifestation, and I really feel that now there's something that you're manifesting. Let me see what I feel with this. And I feel that it's a new way of being in your body. There's like this, you know, it looks like there's a person here, and I don't know, somehow I'm getting that sense. It's like a new way of being sensual in your body as well, you know, just enjoying life. Maybe because of how you are transforming, you are getting to see that you actually have, maybe, you know, when we are in the process of transforming and holding on to old patterns, and you know, we can feel lackluster, like we lack some energy. But now this is changing, because you will have lots, you will be feeling more energy, you'll be feeling invigorated, because you are working with your light. And and because of that, there's going to be these streams of life force that's moving through you. And You can use the violet flame. So if at any point you feel like using this tool to transform something of the old, let's say you have some old emotions related to people, related to a certain situation in your life, and you feel like you're stuck in it, like it's never going to change, you don't have any control over it, you know, then just imagine that person, that thing, that situation, or that organ from inside your body. Imagine it, you know, with these violet flames around it. So even like, and you don't have to think it's something dangerous, you know, it's like you're lighting yourself on fire. No, this is it's light, it's a flame, but it's light. So it's not, it has nothing to do with like physical fire and burning, but it does transform something of a denser quality into a finer quality, you know, a pure quality or a higher quality. So you can use that and see that thing is burning, whether that's you, whether that's your relationship with another person and that connection that you have with them. And you're actually manifesting as a result, you're manifesting that vision that you have. Violet is also the color of the third eye, divine vision. And you're very powerful right now. So whatever transformation that you do consciously, you know, by spending some time on it, by spending more than time, you know, just your awareness, like, you know, you can do these practices or have that intention and really devote yourself to that, and you will see the results. It'll be like magic. It'll happen in front of your eyes. So use the violet flame if you can. Imagine that thing or that connection or that place in your body that feels restrictive, with the violet flame burning it, you know, and transforming it into this just purity, you know, and then you will see in the outer how that actually happens. Whatever you envisioned as that highest purity actually manifests. So enjoy that and let me know what you thought of this message in the comments below. So if you chose number 3, then we're going to pick a card for you here. Let's pick this one. Ooh, you get fairy magic. So just have a look at that. So I don't know about you, but where I live, we haven't been able to get out too much, you know, because of everything that's happening. But otherwise, spring, you know, this spring going into summer, this time is beautiful for spending time with flowers and just, you know, seeing the blossoming of spring and all of that. And that's when we feel this fairy magic. But it looks like you can, you know, you're going to be experiencing it now for yourself, even if that's not available to you. Or maybe, you know, what's happening is that things are opening up a little bit more for you and, you know, you're able to sort of experience that magic. But whether, you know, this magic doesn't have to do with external conditions. In fact, if external conditions are easing up for you, it has to do with your own, what you're feeling within, you know, then that eases up. Or, you know, let's say even if they are sort of semi-restrictive in your external, you will still not experience it as restriction. Like, you'll be able to enjoy that time, you'll find something else. So whatever we're experiencing in the external is always a reflection of our internal state. You know, are we present with whatever's here? So something might be here, we may not fully like it, but can we see the gift in it in that moment? And that's the secret to feeling magic, you know, to living in magic, knowing that we can create whatever we want. Because when we're present with that thing, you see that it transforms into something else. You know, like, let's say it's a relationship with someone and you have a certain dynamic with them, but let's say you're present for the first time while that lower dynamic is playing out. And you don't even have to say anything, do anything different. You're just holding love, you're holding presence, you're just being aware. You're not judging it for the first time, you're just there. You will experience a new magic within yourself. So I just gave you an example of a relationship, but it applies to anything in your life. And there's this, so there's all of these beautiful, lovely colors, you know, like the birth of spring, new life. And that's really, happening for you now. There's like this new magical side of you that's coming out. Let's see, what else am I getting with this? If you can, spend some time with flowers this week because of course fairies relate to flowers, and there's all these flowers in here. They're helping you to remember that inner magic, you know, that you have. Of course, magic is related to synchronicity and manifestations, and this really beautiful light energy of playfulness. So that is what you're manifesting now. There's some surprises coming for you. You know, fairies like to bring gifts, and there's some surprises coming for you this week. So yeah, I hope that you enjoyed that message. Let me know in the comments below, and thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next week.